First of all, thanks for being here in my YouTube channel. So in this lesson number one on the topic probability, we are going to see an overview and introduction about the topic probability. So before solving a question, first of all, you need to know the formula. What is the formula for probability? So probability is equal to sum of observation, which is numerator, divided by possibility is denominator. So this is the formula for probability. So first thing, you need to learn the formula. So probability is equal to sum of observation and divided by possibility. And second important thing, in the question probability, wherever you find the word and, you should multiply it, and wherever you find the word, you need to add it, right? So these are the things that are most important before solving each and every question in the topic probability. And remember that if you are preparing for any IT sector interviews, campus interviews like Wipro company, TCS or IBM, so those IT sector companies, starting from lesson number one till lesson number eight, learn all the lessons. And if you are preparing only for the bank exams, kindly don't learn lesson number 2, lesson number 3 and lesson number 4. So these three lessons are not needed if you are preparing only for the bank exams. And if you are preparing for any CAT exams or GATE exams, any medium level competitive exams, prepare mostly lesson number 5, lesson number 6 and lesson number 7. Why? Because problems that is based on color ball concepts in the probability topic is most important, which we have solved some of the questions lesson number 5, lesson number 6 and lesson number 7. And if you are preparing for any IT sector interviews, kindly learn starting from lesson number 1 till lesson number 8, because all the lessons are most important. So in lesson number 2, we are going to solve some question that is based on coins, and lesson number 3 that is based on dice, lesson number 4 cards, and lesson number 5 will be based upon color ball concept, one bag, two color balls. And lesson number 6, one bag, more than two color balls. And lesson number 7, miscellaneous question. So don't forget to watch all these lessons if you are preparing for any campus interviews. So friends, before solving all the question, these are the three things are most important, right? One is the formula for probability, and second is wherever you find the word and, which is multiplication, and or, which is addition. And another important formula that we use in lesson number 5, let we see that also. Now let we see a small concept on the topic probability, and this concept is applied in lesson number 5, 6 and 7, not in the first three lessons, right? So there are, assume that there are totally, we are having three balls, right? So ball number 1 and ball number 2 and ball number 3. So ball is numbered as 1, 2, 3. Our target to pick two balls. How many chance we can able to pick two balls here? So our target to pick two balls out of these three balls, how many chance we get? Either we can pick 1 and 2, one chance, or otherwise 2 and 3, second chance, a third chance will be 3 or 1. So got it. So we either we can pick first ball and second ball, one chance, or otherwise second ball and third ball, or otherwise third ball and first ball. So totally out of three balls, if our target to pick two balls, the total possible will be 3. So we have totally 3 possible, which is called a sum of observation, right? There are 3 observations where we can pick 2 balls out of these 3 balls. And this can also be written in terms of formula. So listen here, we can write this as 3C2, where C determines combination, and number 3, right here, it determines the total number of balls, and this 2 denotes our target to pick 2 balls. So I have written here as 2. So this 3C2 can be written as, so reduce this number 3 2 times divided by 1 into 2. So this is most important. So listen here, out of 3 balls, our target to pick 4 balls. In case if we are having 4 balls, assume that we are having 4 balls. So 2, 3 and 4. So if there are 4 balls, our target to pick 2 balls, so how many possible? So if they ask like that, you can directly apply a formula. Totally we have 4 balls, our target to pick 2 balls, so 4C2. Got it. If there are 10 balls, for example, if there are 10 balls, our target to pick 3 balls, so we can say that 10C3. And this should be written as, 10 should be reduced 3 times, so 10 into 9 into 8. Got it, friends? This 10 should be reduced 3 times, so 10, 9, 8 divided by, for this 3, 1, 2 and 3. So now you need to cancel this, 3 times, again cancel 1, 4 times. So 4 into 3 will be 12, 12 into 10 will be 120. So totally 120 possible we have if we are going to pick 3 balls out of these 10 balls. Got it? So this is the formula that we are using in lesson number 5, which is most important. Let me take some example, right? Assume that there are 40 balls, right? Assume that there are 40 balls. Out of these 40 balls, our target to pick 2 balls. So how many possible? If the question is like this, then you need to write this as totally we have 40 balls. Our target to pick 2 balls, so 40C2. And this 40C2 should be written as the number 40 should be reduced 2 times. So this can be written as 40 into 39. We are reducing it, right? So 40 into 39 divided by, for this 2, 1 into 2. Now you need to cancel this 20 and you need to multiply this and write this. Got it? If in case we are getting 40C3, how many times you need to reduce the 40? 3 times, only based on this number, right? 40C3, so 40 should be reduced 3 times. So 40 into 39 into 38. So divided by, for this 3, 1 into 2 into 3. So now you need to cancel this and you need to find the answer. So this is the way and this is the formula that we applied in lesson number 5. For lesson number 2, coins, concept is important to solve a question. Similarly, dice and cards. So for lesson number 2, lesson number 3 and lesson number 4, concept is important. We won't apply these formulas. Only for lesson number 5, that is based on balls. So those concepts we will apply this formula, which is combination formula. And another important thing, there is an exceptional case also. In case, if there is 6C2, you can write easily. 12C3, we can write the formula easily, right? We can split this as 12 into 11 into 10 divided by 1 into 2 into 3. It is easy, right? In case, if they ask like this, 12C10. So got it, 12C10. How many times you need to reduce the number? 10 times, right? You need to write 12, 11, 10. Similarly, 10 times you need to write that. So kindly don't do that. You can directly, what you can do is 12 and 10, when you subtract both the numbers, it will be 2. So this can be written as 12C2. Both are same. So got it, friends? Instead of writing 10 times, reducing 10 times this 12, better write this as when you subtract 12 and 10, it becomes 2. So this can be written as 12C2. Similarly, if we have 6C4, this can be written as 6C2, both are same. When you subtract 6 and 4, the resultant will be 2. So this can be written as 6C2. 14C11, if in case it is 14C11, you don't want to reduce this 14 11 times, you can convert this as 14C3, got it? 14 minus 11 will be 3. So once you write this as 14C3, now it is easy, right? So 14 into 13 into 12 divided by 1 into 2 into 3. Now you can cancel this and you can find the answer easily. So this is the basics. If you want to solve question that is based on lesson number 5, 6 and 7, all those lessons. So for the first 3 lessons, it is not needed. Only the formula, that is sum of observation divided by possibility, the formula for probability, right? It is more than enough for it. So let me move on to all the lessons. So don't forget to watch all the lessons from starting till the end. So once you watch all the lessons, definitely you will get an idea how to solve a question on the topic probability. So thank you so much for watching this video, and if you really like it, share this video to your friends, those who are preparing for competitive exams. Bye.